La 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 la.
Frank TV! Hey everybody! Welcome to Frank TV's Xmas special! Please welcome my personal secret Santa, Frank Caliendo!
Just because it's spelled Xmas doesn't mean you pronounce it that way. Anyway, I'm Frank Caliendo. Welcome to the show. And after the show, we're going to do something special. We have a Frank TV Christmas party happening backstage, and you're all invited, huh? We're going to take a look backstage and see what's going on right now.
Missy, you are wound tighter than an 8-day clock. You need help. But I can only lead a horse to water.
Oh, no. It's Dr. Phil.
And Steven, you need to move out of your grandmama's house. Remember, failure is not an accident. Hey, just because a chicken has wings doesn't mean it can fly. I love sayings. Hey, that looks good.
Hey, Dr. Phil, what are you doing here?
Hey, Frank, how are you? I'm just stopping by your Christmas party to help the sick folks who work on your show. I just had no idea there'd be so many of them.
Thanks, but remember it's a party. I don't want you bringing people down, okay?
Don't worry about that. It's gonna be a fun time, Frankie Poo. Hey, is Kwanzaa like the Black Hanukkah? Did I say something wrong?
So sorry you guys had to see that. You know what I like to do when things get uncomfortable? Watch Andy Rooney. He just reminds me of what a great country we live in, where a person can watch somebody slowly go insane on television. What really cracks me up is they still try to make him hip and current, and it never works. Take a look, you'll see what I mean.
I kept hearing all this chatter about a thing called the iPhone, so I finally decided to get one. It looks kind of nice, I guess. Kind of boxy for my tastes. People told me it would fit in my pocket. I certainly don't have pockets this big. I guess young people today think it's cool to wear pants with giant pockets in them. I spent over 12 hours trying to make a phone call with this thing. You know what? I couldn't even turn it on. I tried pressing all these buttons. Nothing.
Andy! Open the box. Take out the stuff inside.
I could try that, I guess. Well, it's lighter now, but it still doesn't pass the pocket test.
Andy, the phone is on the table. It's the small, shiny thing.
Yes. It sure doesn't look like a phone. You're probably wondering the same thing I am. Where's the long, curly cord? Maybe it comes in a separate package. 40 years ago, when I was 75, there wasn't all this packaging. And if you do finally get your iPhone to work, how the hell are you supposed to hang it up? Watch this.
Andy, it's not like a regular phone.
You know what? They should call it a Y phone. Why the hell did I buy this thing? They say it plays music on here, too. Probably plays the kind of stuff kids listen to. Hippie music like James Taylor. Oh, God. Look at it. It's moving around now. Did I buy an iPhone or a Mexican jumping bean?
What an iPhone!
They also tell me you can use a thing called YouTube right on your iPhone. My great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandson also told me that there's a calculator, a calendar, a notepad, and a camera inside this thing. I don't believe him for one second. Look, I'll show you. I don't see a camera there. If this is the phone of the future, I don't need it. I'll just stick with what I have. Hello, operator? Yes, it's TR-6-41. I need to talk to Hillcrest 4 in a jiffy. Yes. I need some sarsaparilla. I'm making a poultice for my shoulder. What's that ticking? iPhone, stop ticking! Did you ever notice every time you start to enjoy a show, they go to commercial? Guess what? We're going to commercial.
Cha-ching!
You're watching the all-new TBS sketch comedy Frank TV on TBS. Brought to you by Verizon Wireless.
Sweetie, got you this new phone with a full keyboard. Because you're my number one. Hey, honey, got you this great phone from Verizon Wireless. Because you're my number one. There you are. Got you this new phone with VCast.
Awesome.
Because, you know, you're my number one.
The part of the show where I bring up an audience co-host. We talked to some people before the show, and this is the person I'm going to go with here. RV Seals. RV Seals. Nice to meet you. How are you? Doing all right? Let's see. RV Seals. What's up with that? RV. What is RV? RV's a different name.
Well, I get that all the time. People, recreational vehicle. That's the number one thing.
It took me a second, but here's a guy who got it. So what do you do for a living?
I work for FedEx. I'm with a courier. Yeah.
That's probably how they should do their commercials. You should be their spokesperson.
I work for FedEx. Yeah.
Have you seen any movies lately?
Yeah, I've seen This Christmas.
Have you seen the Al Gore movie, An Inconvenient Truth?
No.
It's all about how the Earth is slowly being destroyed by people. It won a ton of awards, including an Academy Award. And I'm thinking, if you're Al Gore, you have to do a sequel if you won that award, right? But how do you top that? Here's how.
If you love your planet, if you love your children, you have to see this film. Crisis, planet Earth. There's nothing we can do. We're all gonna die. The sun, that's right, our good friend Mr. Sun, is eventually gonna explode and engulf the Earth. They don't make a sunscreen that can protect you from that. If the sun goes supernova, the high-energy electromagnetic radiation and cosmic rays it releases will destroy the Earth's ozone layer in minutes. And these tinfoil hats we wore in the early days will be of little or no use. Those who do survive the blast from the supernova won't be people anymore. No, they'll be half-alive chicken-fried zombie monsters, motivated only by the instinct to feed on the flesh of their charred brethren. How do we stop it? Oh, we can't stop it. Oh, supernova, why don't you come already? Right about here on the chart is how safe we are. But as you can see, the higher you get, the closer you are to the sun, which is really just a supernova in disguise. Up here, I'm closer to the supernova than all of you are. You can drive an electric car back and forth to the recycling center all day long for the rest of your life, and you will never, ever stop the supernova.
Why are you telling us this?
Let us enjoy our lives.
Honestly, I just like to say supernova. Supernova. It's coming, y'all. Did I get too excited on that?
Uh, let me ask you this. Do you like cartoons?
Oh, yeah.
What kind of cartoons?
A little old school cartoons, you know, like Transformers, G.I. Joe, Alvin and the Chipmunks.
Oh, yeah. You know,
they don't play those no more.
Nothing's as good as hearing that Transformer. Autobots, transform! All right, well, I'll tell you what. It's time for our first Frank TV classic cartoon. Maybe.
What a shame. The only thing I haven't bought yet. Gravity. It's okay. My hair is fine. This time, I can't miss Rosie. She won't know what hit her when I unleashed this Trump fat-seeking missile. It used to be an Acme missile, but I bought them out and changed the name to Trump. You know why? Because that's what I do. That's him.
Meep.
How's the hair? No doubt, Rosie will stop and eat these burgers. And while she's scarfing, that's when I'll release this ginormous Trump anvil. It's the best, most expensive anvil in the world. And splat goes Rosie. But be warned, this won't be pretty. I mean the part where she eats the burgers.
Meep, meep.
What the hell? I had her. When I find the guy who designed this, he's fired. Of course, this means war.
But that's all, folks.
Just take us to commercial now.
All right, we'll be right back with more Frank TV.
Hi, I'm Kevin Nealon here in New York City.
An Elmo doll.
I bet you want an Elmo doll, but I bet you don't want to work for it. Because what you need to do is save your money and buy an Elmo doll for yourself and don't expect a free one from an elf on steroids, okay?
I'm only three.
And you're going to stay only three with that attitude. Come on, get out of here, little man.
Hey, Dad.
I think Dr. Phil needs some air. Can you get him outside away from the party for a little bit? Thanks.
Oh, crap!
Have you ever been a guest on a talk show before?
No.
You know who's a really great guest on a talk show? Charles Barkley. Hosting a talk show, not right for Charles. Here's what I mean.
Hi, I'm Sir Charles Barkley, and welcome to Barkley's Fave Five. Today, my guests are Tom Cruise, Owen Wilson, Ray Romano, Tiger Woods, and my cousin Fuzzy. Tiger, let's start out with you. What do you think we should do about Iran?
Iran? How should I know? I thought we were going to talk about golf and stuff.
Who cares about all that? We already know Tiger Woods, number one, blah, blah, blah. I want to know your thoughts on many topics.
That's not my job. I just worry about getting the ball to the hole with the least amount of strokes.
Oh, see, now that's terrible. That's terrible, terrible, terrible. Iran wants to blow us up, and if they do, your green jacket's not gonna mean shame on you, Tiger Woods. You are out of my five.
What? Are you joking?
Do I look like I'm joking? Come on, get out. You are no longer in my five. There it is. That made me mad. I want to congratulate my four remaining guests. You have all moved up in my five, but now there's an open slot. So please welcome my next guest. He's a legendary broadcaster and has finally made it into my five. Please welcome Marv Albert. Nice to see you, Marv.
Well, the pleasure is mine, Sir Charles. Nice to be in your five.
Today, I wanted to ask my guests what they're doing to improve our environment. I want to start out with my golfing buddy, the butterscotch stallion, Mr. Owen Wilson.
Oh, thanks, Charles. I love the environment. It's awesome.
Well, if you think the environment's so awesome, maybe you should put out that cigar.
Oh, man, why you gotta hate?
I handle this, Owen Wilson. Hey, Ray Romano, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Not you, because you are out of my five. Get out. You are out of my five.
Aw.
Something funny, Fuzzy?
No, Sir Charles. Please don't take me out your five.
You are a thin ass, Fuzzy. You lucky our moms are sisters. I decided to give my next guest a chance to come back to my five. Please welcome back to the show, Tiger Woods.
Charles, I read up on Iran, and I'm hoping we can, together, find a diplomatic solution.
I disagree. I say we bomb them cuckoo birds. The important thing is, Tiger Woods, you are back in my five. My apologies to Tom Cruise. Sorry we didn't get to you today. Until next time, this is Charles Barkley saying, don't make me mad, you knuckleheads, or you will not be in my five.
One of my favorite guys to watch growing up was Johnny Carson. Maybe it's because he was an incredible comedian, or maybe it was because everything he said sounded like it was a punchline. I just can't believe he could do any other job, especially a serious one. Here's what I mean.
It's the NBC Nightly News with John Chancellor. Filling in tonight, Johnny Carson.
Good evening. Welcome to the Nightly News. I'm Johnny Carson, filling in on a snowy night in New York. I hope this works out okay. Our top story tonight, close to 200 Yugoslavian citizens have now been infected with smallpox in the worst outbreak seen anywhere in years. And, this is interesting. Experts warn that despite vaccination, the virus could mutate and become virtually untreatable. Ouch. What are they, bit of a rough start there, huh? Ed, how are we doing?
Not well. Sad news so far.
See how you, see how you like this one. All right, earlier today, a passenger train derailed in western Pennsylvania.
Hey-oh.
The train was heading from Altoona to Pittsburgh when it slid off the tracks. That's not all. Authorities say more than 300 people were maimed or disfigured in the wreckage. Wow.
Bit of a downer.
You heard about the trains then?
Yes. Causes not yet determined. Very troubling.
Okay, let's just keep plugging along here. Let me ask, have you heard about this gentleman, James Burns? James Burns, he served this nation as a senator, a congressman, and a secretary of state under President Truman. Let me tell you, he is so old.
How old is he?
And, he is so old that he passed away late last night due to natural causes. Sad story. Our condolences to the Burns family.
Survived by wife Maud. Very sad.
Yes, yes, it is.
Death is a debt we all must pay. Euripides.
Okay, let's try and mix it up a bit. Here with sports, Karnak the Magnificent, huh? Go.
37-34.
Are you done? 37-34. Here we go. What was the score of tonight's Packers-Cowboys game? See, now that, to me, defeats the purpose of Karnak.
Out of your element without any actual jokes.
All right, well, listen, we're gonna take a break. When we get back, Wall Street Recap with Art Fearn and Joan Embry from the San Diego Zoo brings you the five-day forecast. Right back after this.
Cha-ching.
You're watching the all-new sketch comedy Plant TV on TBS. Brought to you by Bacardi Rum. This holiday season, Bacardi reminds you to drink responsibly.
Come on.
Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring ting tingling too. Come on, this lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Inside, Pollard lays it up and in, and a great move by Marcus Pollard. Probably the most enthusiastic player on this team. Marcus Pollard will get a play. Inside to Winslow, he's open again.
I tell you, when you're, you know, it's happened all night, when you're front down low.
Amos, get that out of here. Take it back to Omaha, baby.
That's the defense.
Blotted out of there by Winslow. What's that, four or five blocks tonight? Winslow taking it himself, baby! Jim Molinari got in on the chip.
Back the other way, Funches. Nice move in the air by Funches. The freshman gets his first two. An 11-4 lead for Drake. 14, another turnover. And there's another one. Billy Wright. Blazing away, Nucky chasing the layup. Billy Wright puts it in.
He's got John Smith right on his tail, but nice. He gives to Jackson. Can't get it, but Pollard's there for the dunk.
Oh, maybe that's just the end of the floor that the offensive rebounds come.
Winslow, fast break.
Well, there's the sin of all sins, Ned. No one getting back.
And Rodney finally gets one, and the Bears are back to a one-point differential. Bradley leading at 38-37.
One on the...
Charles White. That was a dangerous cross-court pass, too. Here's White. Missing Pollard. Ooh. No doubt about it. Well, he left the rim, so... loses control of it. Here's Paul Lusk at the other end. Oh, nice alley-oop to Marcus Timmons. Nice, nice unselfishness by Paul.
Shockers come with the pressure when Broussard comes in the game.
Wow, Charles White goes after KC Hunt. Unbelievable. Charles White just threw KC Hunt to the floor and then wanted some more.
One thing's for sure, both benches stayed there. That's smart.
And now we've got a double technical. Looks like one on John Smith and one on a Bradley player. Here comes Jim Molinari.
Enough with their hands to swat those balls away. Funches, free throw line, jumper is good. That is 12 for Dwayne Funches and Brad Valley. Nice cut to the basket by Charles White.
Excellent timing on that play, the backdoor cut when you're getting pressure.
Only from the field, Taylor loses it and it's Billy Wright with it. Can't hang on to the ball, either team here in the one against Hunter.
Nice
right
pass.
To Winslow for the jam.
Oh, what a pass by Billy right there. No look over the shoulder.
Picked off by Billy Wright. Here he comes for the layup. Billy Wright.
You need to look to score when the shot becomes available. You've got to take the shot.
And they just get it across. Back to Jackson for the jam.
Well, it wasn't pretty, pretty, but a team. Jackson! And they just get it across. Back to Jackson for the jam.
By the Demons, Peter Patton, back to Patton. Trying to get a quick shot here. Bowden open from 16 feet, and it's off the back.
Joey wants his big men down low, not out there.
Offensive foul, wave it off. Peter Patton got in the way of Charles White on the pass by Jackson to Funches, and count that one. A great look by the freshman Deion Jackson, and Funches finished it up nicely.
We talked about it before. These coaches know each other's system. So far, the press by DePaul has gone for naught tonight. I'm sure Jim Molinari worked a lot on that, and you said it.
James within two and another steal, and Wright will shoot for the tie.
Joey may need a timeout.
Good tip.
I'm sure Jim Molinari not happy with that shot. Kind of had a sink, but nice play by Funch.
Curry on the jam, and what do we get? Offensive foul. Into the middle of the lane, and another.
Well, tunnel. He's a freshman.
What a shot by Pollard.
Curry's a freshman.
Knocked away, and what do we get?
Oh, nice
feed. Great pass right to White.
Great play by Wright. Tippy-toed to the sideline, and White streaking down the floor.
Underneath, there's Pollard against Amaya. Good shot. I'm still impressed, Greg. They continue to challenge. Normally, you run into Amaya, you kick it out. They do. Lusk with White chasing. What a defensive play by White. Unbelievable. That's the defensive play of this tournament. Forget the game. Without... A little ball on fire. Nobody could touch it. Nobody could hang on. Here's Funches. Right through. That's a great move. We're talking freshman here, aren't we? Funches. You know, we kept talking about Jackson and Wright. How about
Well, except for that. Anthony Parker, the steal, and the jam. Other end, Harris goes right around. Aubrey tries to do it again. Kicks to Zobrist. Foot on the line. Ooh. All night long, Lee. That young man can shoot a basketball as well as any. Marcus Pollard! Well, they've been looking for that inside pass all day. They finally got it into Marcus, and he threw one down with authority there. That's why he's so important to this team. At the buzzer! It's gonna count. The chainsaw!